Greetings, fruitcakes of the internet, and all pixel and polygon lovers. I have an interesting observation to share with you with regards to OpenGL, or WebGL too for that matter, comparing Linux and Windows performance. Here I have an C++ implementation of an OpenGL app I wrote some time ago, which is doing particle simulation of a million 3D particles, obeying the general gravitational law of Newton. And you can pull around an attracting gravity with the left mouse button pressed and then dragging the mouse around, and do the same with the repelling gravity source while holding the right mouse button pressed and pulling the mouse around. The middle mouse button click clears the gravity source, and it kind of freezes the simulation time, and you can just watch the cloud structure you constructed. It's a lot of fun to play around with that. And as you can see, this is easily hitting 61 frames a second here on the all-Intel laptop I'm running this on, which is sporting an HD 520 GPU. It's nothing fancy by today's standards. There's even a second rendering mode. If you pass 1 on the command line as a parameter, then the particle's speed is mapped to the particle's opacity, so the faster the particle moves, the more visible it becomes. And when you clear the gravity source, then the pull from the gravity source vanishes, and then also the particles stop and become kind of invisible. And then when you hit it again, then they reappear. It's even funkier. It's a lot of fun to play around with this. It's easy to waste a lot of time playing around with it. So much for the C++ implementation. I'll provide links to the Git repository where the code is living in the video description. Now let's move to the WebGL 2 port I did with JavaScript, so you can have that in the browser too. Here, as one would expect, it's the same GLSL code using the transform feedback feature of OpenGL. 1 million particles, and you see it's easily hitting 60 frames a second in the browser, and also the same interaction mapping is happening here with the mouse buttons. Left mouse button drag is the attracting gravity source, right mouse button drag is the repelling gravity source, and the middle mouse button click clears the gravity source. There's also support for the secondary rendering mode here, and there you have the same issue, the same feature with particle speed being mapped to its opacity. The only glitch here is that there's a small yellowish tint going on. That's some blending issue I haven't figured out yet. I'll debug that later, but it's not that important right now, because the main issue here I'm trying to get at is that the performance on Windows is not the same. Well, it is the same for the C++ implementation issues there, especially since my Windows system there is having a solid GeForce GTX 1070. It would be really sad if the implementation there would be not as fast, at least for the C++, for the native implementation. But then on the WebGL 2 side, if I'm using the Windows version of either Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome, I'm only getting kind of 25% of the performance, so I just barely hit 60 frames a second there with a quarter million particles, which is something I do not understand. And yeah, I would really like to get a grip of why that is happening. So I'll provide links to the C++ code on GitHub and to the URLs to the WebGL 2 implementation for you to try it on your system, either Windows or Linux. Linux is not that important, because I'm easily seeing the same performance, so there's not much of an issue. And the Windows side is a little bit more interesting, because I don't know why that is happening. It should work also quite nicely on Android, or at least with Chrome or Firefox browsers, and on iOS. Don't bother with Safari, no matter what system, because just Safari's WebGL 2 implementation is non-existent as far as I know, and the WebGL 1 implementation is also not that good. So please report back if you try it out, and tell me what kind of system setup you have, and what kind of performance you're getting with the WebGL implementation especially. There's some parameters you can pass in the URL here. The first parameter here is the edge size of the simulation volume. So if I pass 150 16 here. It's roughly a little bit over 1.2 million particles. And let's switch it back to rendering mode 1. And here you see easily hitting 60 frames a second again. It would be maybe a little bit better if the screen recording wouldn't be going. Sometimes it's dropping by 5 frames or so, but without the screen recording, it's a really rock solid 60 frames a second. Yeah, that's so much for the moment. Please report back and tell me what issues you're seeing and what kind of performance you're hitting on your systems. Thanks a lot, and talk to you during the next one.